Hi, this is DJ Berard again. I teach acrylic painting at Baker Hunt. Short lesson today is on bleeding skies like watercolors, only in acrylics. It can be done. You can do it with either with paint or acrylic ink. I'll show both today. But the one thing you need to remember is when you thin out acrylics to where it's like watercolors, you break the bonds of the polymers in the paint. It no longer is plastic. Like acrylic paint. What you'll need to use then is an acrylic polymer varnish or acrylic polymer gel, gloss, satin, matte, something to put that polymer back on that pigment when it's dry. It will rub off if you don't coat it with a polymer. What I'm going to do is I've got several paintings today. The first one, as you can see, is the texture here. What it is a textured underpainting, done with gesso, paint. It's a mess. So when the paint was thinned out, it settled into those grooves, much like a watercolor would. So you can do this either with on top of an old painting for the texture. You can do this on watercolor paper. You can do it on a brand new flat canvas, which is what I'm going to show you today. So you'll need paint. A brush. You'll need a spray bottle of water, and if you have acrylic inks, go ahead and get those out. I'm going to get started here in just a minute. Here we go. I've got my palette of red, yellow, and blue, and white. Got a blank canvas. What I'm going to do is just bleed in a sky color-ish. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to get it wet. And I'm talking dripping wet. A little bit of blue. I'm going to take a little bit of red. It's going to run and drip like watercolors. You can add different colors. Add reds, yellows. Ooh, more purple over here. Now what I can do is let it run, much like a watercolor. It's okay, it's dripping on the floor, and I'm okay with that. I'm in the studio. Yeah! And there's my sky. When it gets to where I want, I'm going to lay it on the floor, let it dry. I'll show you that in a little bit. The next one, I'm going to use some ink. Here I've got a tree set up and a wet thumbprint. What I've got is acrylic inks here. They're more expensive than paint. They're about $8 a bottle, depending on the color you get. I've got Liquitex here and some De La Rowney. And just like the last one, I'm going to get this wet. Shake up the ink because they do settle. That darker blue here at the horizon. I wish I had a camera that laid flat so you could see this. You can see how the ink will bleed and run much like watercolors. I'm going to lay this flat to dry. We'll see how it finishes up in the next episode. But like I said, you can use inks or you can thin out your paint with water. Paint well. Have fun. Experiment. But remember, you need to use a polymer on top of these when they're done. Or they're going to rub off, just like a watercolor would. You've broken the bonds of the polymers. You need to add a polymer back on to seal it. Have a good time.